What it do? It's your boy Black Atheist Brands. I'm back with it.
Get okay, Black Atheist.
Make sure you subscribe.
Okay, yeah, let's get into it.
This is a valid question, right? I mean, if God is all knowing and he knew that Satan.
Okay, so we're reacting to a reaction. This is an Inception reaction. Christian explains, why did God create Satan? Let's see if this Christian figured it out. Probably. The answer is free will. God created humans with the ability to choose good and evil. That's the simple answer. Let's see what happens.
We're going to rebel against him, and we're going to have total and complete chaos on the earth. Why in the world would God create Satan in the first place, right?
It's a good question.
Right, because it doesn't make sense to say you love me and then go ahead and create my...
Let's... We're going to be right here.
Enemy. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can destroy my enemy and you choose not to.
It makes sense for him to just create all the good angels and then just not deal with Satan at all. And then life would be a lot better. Well, to answer that question, I want to build upon five premises. And each time I want to build on the previous one.
Let's see. First, before we get into this, I don't consider myself a Christian like this guy does. I have some Christian theological beliefs, but I'm more of an occultist, a mystic, a magician. I come from the occult side. This guy right here is an atheist, a muggle, who probably has no understanding of the occult. This guy right here probably has some understanding of the occult, this Christian, but is likely afraid of it because he looks at his Bible and the Bible tells him not to. That's a whole other story of who wrote the Bible. But this guy probably has a somewhat understanding of God, the source, the creation of all things. Let's just see what he says. God did not create robots.
Robots? Yes, he did.
Let's see what he says.
Premise number one is that God did not create robots.
Yes, he did. Yes, he did. God did create robots. God does create robots. If Christianity is...
Okay, first of all, this guy is not making any sense. You're an atheist. You don't believe in God. Why are you refuting... If you don't understand theology, why are you saying this?
True. And the God of the Bible exists. We are mindless robots because...
No, we're not. He just doesn't understand theology at all.
God controls everything. What are you talking about?
Okay. God doesn't control everything. You being all powerful, it's like there's layers to this. If you can think of God as like you have your body, do I control everything in my body? Yes, in a way. My conscious mind controls my mind and my thoughts. Am I controlling my heartbeat? I mean, I am, because my body is doing it for me, and my body is a part of me, but I'm not consciously controlling like my heartbeat. Like, that's just not how it works. This guy is like, probably has some weird fantasy view of like a God he doesn't even believe in, and he thinks that God is like giving orders and commands like a human. The deterministic viewpoint of what is deterministically happening is the laws of morality, the objective right, the objective wrong. And what I believe this Christian guy right here is trying to say is God did not create robots. We have the ability to choose good or evil. And the fact that humans or anything is able to choose evil creates a new dimension that's separate from the God dimension. Or heaven, as Christians call it. Excuse me. And so, in the mythology, Lucifer falling, or any type of angel falling, that is basically, you can think of it as a chemical reaction, even though it's not chemicals, but it's just the natural reaction of resisting objective morality. You see, in these higher frequency realms, evil doesn't exist. And if it were to exist in the higher frequencies, it sinks, like, you know, something would sink in water. And so you need to understand the concept of multiple dimensions, because in the dimension we're at, we are in a dimension of free will where evil is allowed to contend because of free will. In the higher frequencies, in the higher realms, evil is not allowed to contend. And that's why, you know, they say heaven, there is no evil. If you were to choose evil, you would basically be deleted from heaven, essentially. And so that is kind of just how it works. That's how the angels can fall, is they decide to choose what's wrong and they just don't exist. Kind of like how, you know, an ice cube cannot exist in lava. It just doesn't work. It's just not how the physics work. And so in the metaphysics of spirituality, like, evil cannot exist in those higher realms. And so that's like why an angel is a certain way in these higher frequencies, in these higher realms. They just do what's good always, no matter what. And if they choose otherwise, they fall into our realm. The realm of humanity, the earth plane that we exist in, we have free will. So there is a choice. God did not create robots. I'm basically saying this guy just doesn't understand. He's just too much of a muggle to understand the metaphysics of spirituality and objective morality.
We need to understand and accept the fact that whenever God created angels and also ultimately mankind, he created all of us with free will.
That's right. This guy's right.
It's Cap.
No, it's not Cap. This guy's... He's a muggle. He just doesn't understand.
Cap, we don't have no fucking free will. The God knows you. The God has a plan for you. Everything.
Okay. He's going off of this, like, mythology of God's plan. God does have a plan. But the thing is that we are part of that plan. And it's the way quantum physics works. Is we as humans are in a superposition where there is a plan and there is also the outcome of free will. So we both have a plan and both have a choice. And basically, there's like many different timelines or like infinite types of universes. And every time we make a choice, we go into the timeline universe where that choice leads us. And God knows us because, like, we all have a piece of God in us. If you can think of, like, God as like a massive ocean, and you take like a cup and you like dip it in the ocean and then it's full of like water, that water would be like our spirit. So we have like a piece of it. Another way to think of it is like a sea anemone. You know what a sea anemone is? It's those things that are like in the sea. Well, there's like one central brain, and then like all those tentacles have separate consciousness. We're kind of like the tentacles of God, if you can think about it. I know I'm using a lot of weird analogies, but like it's to understand these like concepts that are beyond humanity, you kind of have to use these analogies. And God's plan is part of like how we choose to go. So like we have free will to like stray from that plan, and that plan that God has for us in a way is created by us in a way. And we also exist in a quantum superposition where we could we are able to act on that plan or not act on that plan, if that makes sense.
Thing that you're doing, that God already created you to do that, if it's true.
See, he doesn't believe in free will, so I don't think he just understands this concept. So because he doesn't understand theology, he's gonna run into a wall.
I'm okay with you blaming me. I'm okay with it being my fault. If I do something bad, I take responsibility. If I do something good, I take responsibility. That's free will. But if you're going to give God credit for the good, guess what you also have to do? You got to give him credit for the fucked up shit that happened.
But that's, God didn't do that. That's the thing. We as humans created evil because we could choose it. And once again, you have to understand multiple dimensions. In the dimension that God resides, which is outside of space and time, and some other entities will reside in, that there is no evil because it can't exist. Like I said, like an ice cube can't exist in lava. We are in the dimension where evil exists. God's plan for us, that saying is kind of mythological in a way. The bottom line is that we have free will, and God is a super conscious that is able to understand what we're going to do and know our choices before we make it, but doesn't intervene to stop us, because that would go against the intention of God's creation, which is free will, human souls. That's why humans are so interesting, because we could choose freely to do right or wrong. The thing that God created was objective morality. This is right. This is wrong. These are the laws. This is what is right. This is what's wrong. It doesn't change. It's always this. These are the rules hard-coded into reality. And it's our jobs as humans to learn that and do what's right. Or you could rebel and do what's wrong and see how far that will get you.
Created us with the ability to choose to obey, to choose not to obey, to choose between good and evil. And if God would have controlled Satan in such a way that it was not possible for Satan to choose evil instead of good, then God would also have been removing free will, which would have been against his original intent for creation.
Well said, actually. That's very true.
Now, with that being said, premise number two, why did God create angels in the first place? Well, the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 1, verse 14, that angels were created to serve and to worship God.
This shit don't make sense to me. You're God. You're all powerful. Why do you need angels? And
okay, I don't think you even, this guy right here, I don't think you understand what you're talking about when you say God. I mean, you're an atheist. You don't believe in God. So, like, what are you talking about? Like, what do you think you're talking about? God is a super consciousness, intelligent entity. The brain of all of reality. The angels, like, think of it this way. The angels serve God. That's the instrument. That is how God interacts in, from God's perspective, the lower dimensions. From our perspective, higher dimensions. See, there's layers to this thing. Like, you have your body, you have cells in your body. And those are your cells. Those are your blood vessels. They do things for you. They serve you. But ultimately, like, your mind, your consciousness, your soul, you are the ultimate arbiter and, like, governor of everything that happens in your body. But your cell, like, the angels are like God's cells, if you can think of it that way. They serve God in the same way our blood vessels and cellular structures serve us, the same way our heart serves us by pumping blood for us. You're not consciously doing it, but your heart is still you. Now, are you going to say, are you your heart? Are you your body? I mean, it's a part of you. Like, in a way, you kind of are, but you're also, like, ultimately your soul, your consciousness. That's who you are. So God is not the angels, but the angels serve God in the same way that our cells serve our body, if that makes sense. That is just how God created reality. It has nothing to do with, like, whatever this guy is saying.
why do you need worship? You know what I'm saying? I just can't wrap my head
Worship, once again, that's just a mythological concept that is in the Bible to kind of make sense of the metaphysics of God's creations.
Around that.
It says here, therefore, angels are only servants, spirits sent to care for people who will inherit salvation. So
let's cut out the, you know, I want to cut out the middleman. Why are you sending angels to do what you could do? You know what I'm saying?
What are you talking about? This guy really has no fucking idea what he's talking about. Like, who? Like, do you even know what you're saying? Like, what you're saying doesn't make any sense. Cut out.
Sense to me that if God is all powerful, can't he just come down and help me himself? Why he got
come down and help me himself? Like, what do you think that looks like? Tell me, what does that look like? God doesn't have a body. God isn't like a dude that could just talk to you, like knock on your door and like say, hey dude, what's up? Like, do you want me to help you out? Like, do you think God is like, he is probably expecting some like all-powerful wizard to just poof with like a human body to come down and like talk to him like a human and be like, here you go. Basically, now this is what Christians believe Jesus is that manifestation, that God did come down in a human body. I have a different viewpoint of what that is. Now I can see some of the Christians' points, but I don't want to get sidetracked. This guy, he is asking all the wrong questions. The way God comes down to help you is by sending entities, because the massive nature of God, like the superstructure of what God is, like an all-powerful intelligence that exists outside of space and time, physically cannot come down and just like say, what's up, bro, and like help you. So if you want to use the terminology the middleman, these angels, these servants, is how God expresses that will to help us. And that is all that is needed. Those are the cells. Like, imagine this. Am I just going to go inside my body and repair? Like, say I got a cut on my hand. Am I just going to, like, go inside my body and like be like, hey blood vessels, I need you guys to clot up and like stop my bleeding, okay? Can you do that for me? No, it's just gonna, the my body has like the DNA just programs my blood to just do that automatically. Like, it's, they're my servants. My blood vessels are my servants. It just does it for me. So like, that's what the angels are. He's like personifying and humanizing God in a weird way that doesn't make any sense. So he's confusing himself.
Gotta send somebody. Why? You know what I'm saying? Like, have you seen those movies where like, okay, your dad is always working. He never have time for you. And you think he's coming to take you to the park, but it's his secretary. It's his understudy.
Like, see, he's this poor dude. He has no fucking idea what he's talking about. He like thinks God is a human. Like, these stories are relevant. You don't understand theology.
Like, damn, daddy, why you always sending your secretary to take me to the park get ice cream? Why won't you that busy? You can't come do it yourself?
He doesn't know what he's talking about.
How you gonna tell me that this is we supposed to be seeking a personal relationship with God, and then he don't even come do it himself? He's sending angels and shit.
We must understand that God's initial or original intent in creating Satan is that God did not create Satan. God actually created Lucifer. So we have to understand that the word Lucifer is...
Okay. This is where I would kind of... The Lucifer story, even in the Bible, is a little sketch. I think what's more accurate is the Gnostic interpretation. I think Lucifer is like an analogy for Sophia, but that is that's really getting the weeds. But I could understand the mythology of how I don't know. I just believe in a different mythology than the Lucifer mythology. But let's the concept of like falling from grace, falling from heaven, lowering your frequency so you could choose evil, is still valid in this mythology that I don't subscribe to.
It's a positive name. It's a beautiful name. It actually describes God's most beautiful created angel of all time. It means the son of the morning dawn. Now the word Satan and the devil and other names are names that has been assigned or attributed to Lucifer as a result of him making the decision to turn away from God. And these words are more negative in nature, such as Satan means adversary and the devil and so on and so forth. So the idea is this: God created Lucifer with free will. Lucifer then exercised that free will to choose evil instead of good. And at that time, his name was changed from Lucifer to Satan. But
God knew what Lucifer would choose before he created him, and he still created him that exact way. I give all...
Yes, that's right. But you see, God creates everything, every possible thing that can exist. And there's also, like, this is the thing that I don't know if Christians or atheists, muggles, they're both muggles, in my opinion, understand, like, multiple timelines and how there are, like, timelines out there, in realities, potentially. I'm kind of speculating, but potentially where Lucifer, let's say, didn't choose to rebel. We're currently in a timeline where this happened this way. God allows everything to happen and doesn't stop it because, you know, that's the whole free will thing. So let's just see what this guy's issue is.
All of the fault is on the God. We got to...
Okay, once again... fault, it's not, I mean, yes, I guess you could say it's God's fault, and what, like, that's the reason, free will. The intention of God is to have these creatures have free will. Now the angels are servants and don't have free will in the same way that humans do. However, if like they are strong enough to like resist, they basically like revoke their angel's status. And that's like what an angel is. It's like an angel is basically a servant that like virtually doesn't have free will. And if it exercises its free will in the wrong way, then it's no longer an angel. It basically just, it gets fired. And that's what, you know, in this mythology, Lucifer did. Exercise its free will to choose something else. And yes, God knows that because God knows everything, but God doesn't stop it because that's just not how God created the universe to be.
Understand, when we're talking about God, we're not talking about a human being having a child where, like, you know, it's your child, but you can't really control exactly what they thinking. You can't really control exactly what your child grows up to do. But when it comes to God, he can. Right? So,
yeah, but God didn't do that.
Oh, if you're going to tell me, oh, well, God created Lucifer, God didn't create Satan, God didn't create him to rebel. Well, if to follow that same notion, God didn't create Jesus Christ to die for our sins. That was his choice. That was his free will.
Yeah. That. All I gotta say is, like, what's your point? Like, the thing is that, yes, God created things that happened in a way where you may perceive negatively, but I don't think if God would intervene, like, the consequences are, like, reality would just break. It wouldn't be the same reality that you're used to. Again, the fundamental thing is God did not create robots. God created things that have the choice to have free will. And as we saw in the first parts of this video, he doesn't really accept that premise. So because of that misunderstanding, he's getting confused by a lot of these concepts.